In this session, we are finding inverse Laplace transforms to tan inverse, logarithm, cot inverse to some special functions. Already in the last video, we determine L inverse to logarithm and tan inverse. And here also, again, we are finding L inverse to logarithm, tan inverse and cot inverse. But once understand the difference between these two problems, here they ask, find L inverse of. Actually, here we are comparing the problem with L inverse f bar of s. So, the function under L inverse is f bar of s, means we are taking f bar of s as logarithm function as well as tan inverse. Already from the basic definition, we know L inverse f bar of s means f of t. To find this f of t corresponding to f bar of s, we are applying multiplication by t property and we are finding. But here the problem is L inverse of integral. So actually integral s to infinity we will get in the division by t property. Laplace transform of 1 by t f of t equivalent to integral s to infinity f bar of s ds. So if you shift L to another side, you will get L inverse integral s to infinity f bar of s ds equal to 1 by t f of t. So L inverse of integral s to infinity f bar of s ds is 1 by t f of t. Now compare the problem L inverse integral s to infinity in place of f bar of s tan inverse a by s ds. So the solution to this problem is not like this, simply f of t. To this problem under L inverse together with f bar of s to infinity there, that is, this is a problem on indirectly from division by t property. So here the solution is, to all the problems if you compare the problem with this one, the solution is 1 by t f of t. So here the first problem, f bar of s means tan inverse a by s, that is L inverse integral s to infinity f bar of s ds. So f bar of s is tan inverse a by s. Corresponding to this f bar of s, find out f of t. That is possible again by using multiplication by t property. So we know Laplace transform of t f of t equal to minus 1 d by ds of f bar of s. So minus 1 d by ds of f bar of s is tan inverse a by s. It is equal to minus 1 d by ds of tan inverse x is 1 by 1 plus x square in place of x a by s. Now to this one, tan inverse derivative is 1 by 1 plus x square, but for a by s we have minus a by s square. Now minus minus plus, and if you simplify you will get s square by s square plus a square into a by s square. So a by s square plus a square, this is a Laplace transform of t f of t. We are applying here multiplication by t property to find f of t corresponding to f bar of s. To find this f of t from this f bar of s. So to have f of t, shift L to another side. That is L inverse of a by s square plus a square. L inverse a by s square plus a square means this is a Laplace transform to sin a t. So we require only f of t. So f of t equal to shift t to another side, 1 by t. So f of t corresponding to this f bar of s. But to this problem solution is L inverse integral s to infinity f bar of s ds. This is our problem. Solution is 1 by t f of t. That is, we know L inverse integral s to infinity tan inverse a by s ds equal to 1 by t f of t. two these problems, solution is 1 by t f of t. So 1 by t, and corresponding to this f bar of s, f of t is 1 by t sin a t. So 1 by t square sin a t. So the main objective of this problem is, the problem is mainly L inverse integral s to infinity f bar of s ds, that is 1 by t f of t. So if you know f of t corresponding to this f bar of s, easy to write down the solution. To find this f of t corresponding to this f bar of s, that is to this f bar of s, to find f of t, we are applying multiplication by t property. Actually, the problem is from division by t property. To find out this solution, we are applying first division by t property. We understand the problem belongs to division by t, and after understanding that, corresponding to this f bar of s, to find f of t, we are applying multiplication by t property. And the next problem is, do this problem on your own. Find L inverse of integral s to infinity log of s plus a by s plus b. Now I am doing the problem. Find L inverse of integral s to infinity cot inverse s plus a by b ds. Here the problem we have to compare with L inverse integral s to infinity f bar of s ds. The solution is 1 by t f of t. By using this property, this is our problem. So if you compare these two, f bar of s is cot inverse s plus a by b. Now corresponding to this f bar of s, to find f of t, we are going to apply multiplication by t property, that is Laplace transform of t f of t equal to minus 1 d by ds of f bar of s. So minus 1 d by ds of f bar of s is cot inverse s plus a by b. It is equal to minus 1. Derivative of cot inverse is minus 1 by 1 plus s plus a by b whole square. Cot inverse x, d by dx of cot inverse x equal to minus 1 by 1 plus x square. According to that, d by ds of cot inverse function into 2 the inner 1, derivative is for s by b, derivative is 1 by b, plus for a by b 0. Now minus minus plus, and if you simplify, b square by b square plus s plus a whole square into 1 by b equal to b by s plus a whole square plus b square. This is Laplace transform of t f of t. Our aim is to find f of t corresponding to this f bar of s. So f of t equal to, before that one, t into f of t equal to shift L to another side. So L inverse b by s plus a whole square plus b square. Here b by s square plus b square, that is Laplace transform of sin bt, and s changes to s plus a, that is because of e power minus a t. So f of t equal to 1 by t e power minus a t sin bt. We find f of t corresponding to this f bar of s, but to the problem, the solution is 1 by t f of t. This is our problem. This is our problem. Corresponding to problem, the solution is 1 by t f of t. Up to now, we determine only the f of t. So, solution to the problem is cot inverse s plus a by b ds is 1 by t f of t. F of t is again 1 by t e power minus a t sin bt. That is 1 by t square e power minus a t sin bt. And I left one problem to you. L inverse integral s to infinity log of s plus a by s plus b.